Kdenlive is mathematically the best video editor for Linux. So if you just want to leave, now with the answer, you can leave. But I don't mind showing my work. First of all, let's get all the video editors that are commonly used. There's a bunch. Now let's eliminate all those that don't work on Linux. That's most of them gone. Now let's eliminate all those that you need a NVIDIA graphics card to use. Yeah, that's the one most people talk about. And now let's just get rid of all those that are a little too bulky or a little unpolished. And there's Kdenlive. There you go. Now, why should you listen to me? I'm just a random guy on the internet. And that is true. I am just some random guy on the internet. But I'm a random guy on the internet who likes playing with editing software. And I have used quite a few. I started with Premiere Pro, played around with Sony Vegas, Lightworks, OpenShot, played some time with DaVinci Resolve. I mean, I did technically start with Windows Movie Maker, but I don't know how much people consider that true video editor anymore, even though it totally is. So I've used all of these. Let's just put them over here. Whoa, look at all those video editing softwares. Now, am I going to say that Kdenlive is a better piece of software than DaVinci Resolve? It's not. There's a reason why a lot of people who are getting out of Premiere now use DaVinci Resolve. It's a very robust piece of software. But for me, the problem is you can only use it with NVIDIA graphics cards on Linux, and that's not very compatible with all my systems. But other than that, DaVinci Resolve is a really good piece of software. And I would honestly recommend it if you're going to be sticking with NVIDIA for the long term. Every once in a while, I'll go back and check. Because once in a while you'll see on like Reddit and stuff that they're going to get AMD support, but I don't believe in it anymore. Okay, now let's stop talking about DaVinci Resolve and talk about what I actually use, which is Kdenlive, which probably makes me a little biased towards it. So what is Kdenlive, or KDE Nonlinear Video Editor? Well, it describes itself as an open source video editor that started in 2003, and it's built on Qt and KDE libraries. While most of the video processing is done by MLT Framework, which relies on many other open source projects. But all that you need to understand is that it's a video editor that runs on basically every operating system. So when I first fully switched over to Linux, as in I didn't have a Windows PC anymore, I realized I couldn't run Sony Vegas anymore. So I went searching for a good piece of video editing software. And honestly, there weren't many options. So I ended up using Kdenlive. It's a pretty simple piece of software to get started with, but I don't know how simple it really is. Like, I like editing videos, and I've been editing videos since Windows released Windows Movie Maker with Windows. So I think like XP, I think. So I don't honestly know how simple it is, but if you've used a piece of video editing software, it's pretty simple to pick up. And at the same time, it has quite a bit of capability under the hood. Even though at the time it was quite an underdeveloped piece of software. Honestly, I was stuck with it and now it's pretty decent. So I don't know, there might be a little bit of Stockholm syndrome going on. But if you go to their website, you can see their roadmap and everything. And it's honestly quite impressive how much they've improved the program throughout the years. Now, is Kdenlive the best piece of software there is? Honestly, no. It still has quite a bit of rough edges to it. For example, it still doesn't have hardware acceleration, like GPU accelerated rendering or anything like that. So you need a pretty decent CPU to render it quite fast if you're using higher resolutions. GUI will sometimes just randomly mess up, and you just have to close it down and reopen it again. I mean, as with all video software, like video editing software, it crashes a whole lot. But like every single piece of video editing software I use crash a lot. I don't think it crashes more often than Premiere, but it definitely doesn't crash less often than Premiere does. At least the Premiere I used quite a few years ago now. And Sony Vegas also crashed a crap ton too. See, I did play around with DaVinci Resolve quite a bit, but for some reason it just rubbed me the wrong way. I don't know, I didn't like the vibe, which is not a smart way of deciding which piece of editing software you like, but it's the way I ended up picking the piece of editing software I like, I guess. As for Kdenlive, it does everything I need it to do. So, every video on this channel I've made using Kdenlive, and I've worked on some other video editing projects on some other channels using Kdenlive. And I have a bunch of like dead channels that I've uploaded like one or two videos on. I've basically been on Kdenlive for quite a few years now. Wow, I have been using Kdenlive for a while now. I honestly didn't even think about it. Okay, how long can we... Now, if you're just getting into video editing, you don't need Kdenlive. I mean, it's a free piece of software. Download it if you want to. But I would honestly recommend trying out OpenShot for a little bit. OpenShot is basically Windows Movie Maker. It's very simple, it's very basic, and it gets the job done for 99% of people. If you're really trying to get invested in video editing, I would recommend fully going into Kdenlive. And if you start with OpenShot and try to transfer over to Kdenlive, it's actually quite a simple transfer. Kdenlive is basically just like an upgraded version of OpenShot to me.
Also, like this video if you liked it, and subscribe if you still want to subscribe. I don't know. I realize if I don't say it, no one does anything. So, if you want to, just a reminder. Oh, and YouTube recommends video here. This video, YouTube recommends. Thank you. Bye.